So, whenever you want to demonstrate in science or technology, you have to talk in terms of some elementary mathematics, not like a mathematician. Remember, you are supposed to be utilizing mathematics for a particular purpose. So, let's try to understand that crystalline solid must be periodic. Therefore, can I have a periodic function is the question. If I can construct a periodic function, then I will be able to understand what the periodic crystal is all about. So now I am trying to construct a periodic function, first in one dimension, then in two dimension, then in three dimension. Is that argument clear? We want to understand a crystalline solid. All crystalline solids are periodic in nature. So, can we construct a periodic function? We shall be constructing first in one dimension, then two dimension, and then in three dimension. So, in one dimension, we are trying to construct. And we will be asking ourselves a question that if this is the vector and I write a function m1 a1 where m1 is integer from minus infinity to plus infinity through 0. Minus infinity to plus infinity through 0. Now let us try to put this function on a number line. Let us take the magnitude of A1 for our convenience to be around a centimeter. Right? So, we can draw a line and if we forget what is in between, then it is trying to jump from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and vice versa in the negative direction, 0 to minus 1, minus 1 to minus 2, minus 2 to minus 3. Am I correct or not? Therefore, it looks like a step function or not. Right? So, wherever it is the integer, I can put a point at every 1 centimeter. If I take magnitude of A1 to be 1 centimeter, along the direction, because this is a one-dimensional case, then I will be able to put points at 0 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 5 centimeter, and also in the negative direction. Is that correct or not? So please put that point in your on a line so that we understand what we have understood. You try to put roughly 1 centimeter, you must have the sense of 1 centimeter. Go to the negative direction as well. So you move towards left as well as to the right. Right now, we are dealing with a one-dimensional case. So, did you generate a point set on a number line? Right? Now, all those collection of points on that number line, is this periodic or not? After every 1 centimeter of the distance, you are definitely going to hit a point. And now I am using a technical term. That point in crystallography is known as lattice point. Right? All those points set on a number line is said to be a lattice point. So therefore, a lattice, a one-dimensional lattice is a collection of one on a number line, on a line. And all my statements are going to be valid for Euclidean space. Right? It is not a non-Euclidean space. All our crystals are at the moment in this class is going to be Euclidean crystal. And what is a Euclidean space? Euclidean space is one where your Pythagoras theorem is applicable. Euclidean space is one where the triangle will have, the summation of the triangle must be 180 degrees. Right? So therefore, whenever this is violated, you are not dealing with a Euclidean space. So that becomes a non-Euclidean space. But my crystals are faithful, they are quite reliable, they are Euclidean in nature. So whatever you have done in one dimension, can you do it in two dimensions as well? Yes, let's try to do it in two dimensions. In two dimension, obviously you have to introduce two variables because you are in two dimension. M1 and M2 are the integers. So it will become M1A1 plus M2A2. So, can you map it again in the two-dimensional space? Yes. For convenience in this class, what we will do is that we will make A1 and A2 to be equal. A1 and A2 vectorially should be 90 degrees to each other. So, what kind of shape are you going to generate? A square. Is that correct or not? So, please generate that. So it will be just like your graph sheet. The only thing is that you are not supposed to be drawing the line. So in this class what we will do is that we will try to draw the line and then have the vertices, forget about the line. So we are dealing with only the point set in the two dimensional space. So a collection of periodically spaced set of points shall constitute a two-dimensional lattice. Is that correct or not? Please, science is quite natural. Don't think very unnatural. Don't be complicated. Science is very, very simple. Please don't think it in a complicated way. To begin with, finally the actual system is going to be complicated. But to understand the physics of the problem, don't do anything very, very complicated. I said, you draw a square, what you could have expected is that periodically spaced line then I have requested you that you put points on the vertices and forget about the line. So, do you see a point set? Yes. Are they periodic in nature? Yes. For example, if I ask you the coordinate of this, what are you going to write with respect to this as the origin? 1, 1. Are they integers? Yes. So, this is basically a collection of points in two-dimensional space where all the coordinates are given by a combination of two integers. Right? Can I write similar expression for three-dimensional space? Answer to this question is yes. So let us try to write it. So this time we will be using three integers are the variable. So write three integers as the variable. So let us try to construct the most simple case. What is the most simple case? A1 equal to magnitude of A1, magnitude of A2, magnitude of A3 to be equal, and all these vectors are mutually orthogonal to each other. So therefore this becomes a cube. So there is a cube, side by side there is a cube, cube and cube. And finally, if I ask you that all the vertices of the cube, if you start giving me the coordinate, so how the coordinate will read like integer, integer and integer only. So now you forget about the line of the cube, think of only the vertices, and that vertices are periodic in all the three directions. And that collection of points shall constitute a three-dimensional periodic lattice. So how many types of things I have told you by now? One-dimensional lattice, two-dimensional lattice, three-dimensional lattice. So we will say lattice in general is periodic arrangement of points in n-dimensional space. So in n dimensional space, therefore, you will be writing m1, m2, m3. This should be equal to summation mi ai I equal to 1 to n. I have constructed therefore a n dimensional lattice through this expression. Absolutely there is no problem. For all this, it has got a wonderful characteristic. Let's look at that characteristic. Take any lattice point, right? Take any lattice point. Suppose that if I take any lattice point 1, 0, 0 in three-dimensional space, you will be writing at 1, A1 cap, A1 plus 0, A2 plus 0, A3. This is definitely a lattice point. All 3, 0 also is a lattice point. And what is the extension? From minus infinity to plus infinity. Therefore, origin is going to be a trivial case. That is unimportant. Always remember that if you remember it, irrespective of the discipline, you will be a happy man. That vectors, they don't have any origin. Remember this forever. Vectors don't have any origin. Lattice also don't have any significance to the origin. It is only for writing something that we are using it. Otherwise, it does not have any sanctity. If you change the origin, nothing is going to be changing. Right? Because it is expanding from minus infinity to plus infinity. That's the. For example, if I say that the plane normal of this wall is this vector, some vector, do I have to specify to know the location of this wall on latitude and longitude by specifying the magnitude of the normal? Not at all. For example, the plane normal of this wall and the plane normal of this wall is one and the same. Are they located at the same place.
Now physically I can see it is there.
And it is there. So often I construct an example that whenever you have confusion, you remember Banaras, remember Ganga, and recall the Ganga is flowing in the north direction. Then you should have naturally gone to Himalaya. It doesn't go, it goes to Bay of Bengal. Therefore, origin, they don't have any meaning. Vectors are known only because of sense. It is flowing north only in the sense, not in the location. So the location is trivial, and that is what I am demanding while teaching crystallography. And nothing else. Right. Now I am saying that if I add this vector directly, then you will be getting a point 1 plus n1 comma 0 plus n2 comma 0 plus n3 as another coordinate. I am not doing anything. I have just added here. So you add it. So look at the coordinate. Collection of coefficient of a1 is n1 plus 1, n2 plus 0, n3 plus 0. Now I am asking, is that a coordinate also a lattice point?
Yes.
That means this is invariant with respect to translation. So lattice point is invariant with respect to translation. If 0 exists, yes, I can construct two vectors, m1, m2, m3, and another coordinate, minus m1, comma, minus m2, comma, minus m3, and if I add it together, I get a null vector. Is that correct or not?
Yes.
Given m1, m2, m3, do I have a lattice point at minus m1, comma minus m2, comma minus m3? So that means it is closed, it is invariant under group addition and the group subtraction. I don't have to make the other statement. This is not the way that we should be teaching. We should simply say addition. Subtraction is automatically in the vector space is included. Right? So therefore it's a closure operation. So that means indirectly I have taught you that whatever the translation I am writing that is closed under addition, vectorial addition. So it is forming a group. Since every time you are trying to jump from one point to the other, therefore you are translating yourself. So it is a translation group. This is a vector space. This is a translation group in crystallography. In general, it is an integer vector space. Now, we will be introducing one more technical term for you. I ask you a question that how many number of integers you see in one dimension?
One.
Variable. Range is minus infinity to plus. In two dimensional space? In three? So how many integrally independent basis vector you see in one dimension? Integrally independent basis vector. In one dimension? Are you able to see or not? If I specify the direction of A1, along with its magnitude, you exactly know all the lattice points. If I keep moving one step, one step, one step, one step, or any integer step for that matter, you are going to hit the lattice point only. So, the number of integrally independent basis vector is technically known in crystallography as the rank of the solid. You have to break your teeth. Integrally independent basis vector, number of integrally independent basis vectors. A1, A2, A3, they are known as the basis vectors. Do you have finite number of translation vectors? Yes. Do you have finite number of vector indicating a point to have the finite expanse? No, because you have said all the NIs are expanding from minus infinity to plus infinity. So all the vectors, they have got infinite extension. So even if I am trying to draw one unit cell, one unit of a square, what it means is that is infinitely many. So I have already therefore told you about rank, about lattice, about one dimensional lattice, basis vectors and all these things. So you can write the summary whatever I have told you just now. Please write here the summary. Summary whatever I have told you so far. And having written it, you try to exchange the copy with the next nearest neighbor. In case you are missing any point, you should be able to take it from the others. After a couple of minutes, you can exchange your notes and then again get back your notes and see if you are missing any point that your colleague has understood better than you or worse than you. So whenever the summary, you should be able to see what is a lattice, that answer must come automatically. You should also be able to see that you have noted about the basis vectors, because this is what we have been emphasizing. You should also be able to see definition of rank in your write-up. And all these three, if you have captured, that means you have understood. And closure operation, it is trying to form a group. This is what I have told you so far. It is closed under addition, vector addition. So therefore, whatever I have taught you is basically the translation group. If these are the vectors, then I can take a dot product as well. Is that correct or not? Absolutely, there is no problem. I can take the dot product as well. So let us try to see. We will be doing for three dimensions only. So if I have one three-dimensional vector, one three-dimensional vector as u1 a1 plus u2 a2 plus u3 a3. All these are integers. It is just like your m1, m2, m3. I take another vector, let us call it as 1, and another vector r2. Now b1 a1. Now you have understood that why I have changed the alphabet, because I wanted to take 2. Otherwise, many book will be writing this as m1 superscript 1, m2 superscript 1, m3 superscript 1, and next time it is going to be m1 superscript 2, but I want to avoid that. So b1 a1 plus b2 a2 plus b3 a3, where ui's are integers, vi's are also integers. Because I cannot challenge the basic premise of my lattice. This is what a lattice is, a three-dimensional lattice. So, I will be able to therefore calculate the angle between these two vectors, r1 dot r2 divided by magnitude of r1 and magnitude of r2. And if I give you, can you calculate it? So you are supposed to tell me, you can calculate it either yes or no. When can you calculate it? What is the input that you demand from me? Please write that. How do I really compute this? What are your demands? Right? All computation has got the famous Gigo criteria, that garbage in and the garbage out. So you should be able to ask the right question to the person who has asked you to compute. So you are supposed to be asking me the input. So please write that these are the inputs which are required. Input for computing this. You have done it many a time. You are very efficient in doing that. So this is just to test. How do you ask the question? Are you asking the precise question? Remember, A1, A2, A3 need not be your classical IJK. I have never said it. So what are the questions that you are going to ask so that you can compute it? So you write that in what way, when do you know the three vectors? Input, you write. What is meaning of your statement that must be known? What does it mean? Why did you write like this? Write this is wrong, because I have never said that A1, A2, A3 are IJK of your high school days. And you will remember it and finally you will be getting zero. I am not worried for getting zero. I am worried that you have not understood my question. Yes. So, now you try to match. If, did you ask the question that the way I am asking? If somebody has asked me to compute this, I will say, sir, can you get me the magnitude of A1, A2, A3? That's the first point. Then I will also ask that, sir, will you be kind enough to tell me what is the angular relationship between A1 to A2, A1 to A3, A2 to A3? So how many parameters I must specify to you? 6. Wonderful. And this is the basis of the crystal system. What is the basis of the crystal system? 6 parameters. And so you have told me, so I am going to summarize it. You wanted input from me to compute this for a given set of 2 vectors. The first one is magnitude of A1 you want, magnitude of A2 and the magnitude of A3. This is the first thing, right? Then you wanted angle between A1 and A2. Normally, this is how the angle we write. Angle between A1, A3. Angle between A2, A3. These are the 3 angles. So, any 3 dimensional shape can be specified by this. For example, let us take that all the magnitude are equal, all of them are 90 degree, what kind of shape you visualize? So therefore, the first shape is cubic, which is nothing but A1 magnitude equals to magnitude A2 equals to this, and angles are at 90 degree. This is the first crystal system. If you look at Raghavan, this is what it is, cubic crystal system. So it doesn't come from anywhere. It comes by following the proper path. See, how did I construct this? I have constructed that I have a serious crisis of computing the 2 vectors, angle between 2 vectors. So what question I should be asking? That exactly the people must have asked, and they got the that there are 6 in general lattice parameters. Those parameters in crystallography are known as lattice parameters. Normally, they will not be writing in terms of A1, A2, A3. Rather, they will be asking that there are three magnitude A, B, C. Now, I don't have to write the vector because I am saying the magnitude. And there are 3 angles, alpha, beta and gamma. See, if I give you alpha, beta and gamma, A, B, C magnitude, you will be able to do it very nicely. So just for fun, let us try to construct a shape where, please write, A equal to B, not equal to C, alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree. So please draw that. You draw that equal to 90 degree. So please draw that. So from the cubic, how can you get this shape? How do you get this shape? Don't repeat it. I give you a metallic cube and finally I ask you that, no, you try to convert it into this shape. What are you going to do? Or compress? Both. Both are possible solutions. So this also is a natural descendant of a cube. Right? This in crystallography, this shape, A equal to B, not equal to C, alpha equal to beta, equal to gamma, equal to 90 degree, in crystallography is known as tetragonal shape. So the next hierarchy will be A not equal to B, not equal to C, alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree, orthorhombic. This is going to be orthorhombic. Like that, you can have monoclinic, triclinic, right? So now we will be doing one more exercise and then we will stop it today. So you try to construct a shell, a geometrical shape, right? A equal to B, not equal to C, A equal to B, not equal to C, right? And gamma equal to 120 degree, alpha equal to beta equal to 90 degree. Have you drawn it, you rectamorphalos? I have told you, think naturally and simply. You have been taught wrongly that you should realize first. जब आप हमको हेक्सागन खींच करके दिखा दीजिए तो इतने पैरामीटर से खींचिए बच्चा लोग, जरा देखें कैसे हेक्सागन मिलता है इनको। अरे आपको, हमने आपको कहा ए इक्वल टू बी नॉट इक्वल टू सी, आप छह फेस के बारे में तो मैंने आपको इंफॉर्मेशन ही नहीं दिया है। आई हैव जस्ट गिवन यू इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट थ्री फेसेस ना, so why are you just getting biased by your opinion? And as a consequence of this, we will be teaching something wrong. Thanks that you are in Banaras, otherwise this is how it is taught. Whatever we say in Banaras in this respect, world will say. That's the arrogance. Many of the familiar names of this place you will find on the International Table on Crystallography. So whatever we say, world has to say. Including my name also. फिर हेक्सागन आपने खींच दिया रे बच्चा, कैसे हेक्सागन लिया आपने? I cannot believe it. तो 120 डिग्री के लिए हेक्सागन जरूरी है, नहीं ना? You should have drawn one third of this cell. उसके अलावा तो मैंने कोई इंफॉर्मेशन ही आपको नहीं दी, ना मालूम कहां से कंस्ट्रक्ट कर लिया आपने। नहीं कंस्ट्रक्ट करना है, ये गलत है, ठीक है? वो मटेरियल बदल जाएगा, इसका चेहरा बदल जाएगा माय डियर फ्रेंड। अभी हम ज्योमेट्रिकल शेप केवल ड्रॉ करवा रहे हैं। Eventually, they have to map to the real structure. हमको लगता है कोचिंग वाले ने इतना काम कर दिया कि हमको कुछ करने के लिए नहीं बचा है। बाप रे बाप, अरे मैं भी प्रोफेसर हूं यार, मेरा भी बात मान लो। ड्रॉ करो, हमको मालूम है 12 बजे के बाद में आप खाने के लिए जाते हैं, सो आई नो इट। यस, आपके पास क्लास नहीं है। ओके, Most of you have, biased by your previous learning, you have drawn a hexagon as the base. How many A equal to B and the angular relationship of 120 degree shape you can, two dimensional shape you can see in the base? Okay. Parallelogram kaha? Abhi to main plane mein pooch raha hoon babu. The hexagonal plane that you have drawn, how many shape of A equal to B and angle between A vector and the B vector 120 degree, how many shape, geometrical shape you see? Three. Right? So I have given you input only for one of them. Is that correct or not? So there is going to be a rhombus in the plane, another rhombus on the top of it, and the and distance between the separation of the two is going to be C. Is that correct or not? So basically, whatever you have been taught is uniquely W, R, O, and G. Right? So, please don't follow Raghavan book for that reason, that, because they are not crystallographers. Raghavan had been a student from this metallurgy department. You should know that. Okay? MIT product, professor at IIT Delhi, super MIT. So, aap mun karke keh dena, achha material scientist hai, yahi ka hoga. No doubt about it. Okay? So, now, you have understood that that is the cell. उसको तीन बार हम कर देंगे तो वही आ जाएगा जो आप हाई स्कूल में पढ़ के आए थे, जो कोचिंग वाले ने पढ़ाया, इतना पढ़ाया कि इतना बड़ा प्रोफेसर क्लास में परफॉर्म कर रहा है तो भी नहीं, ठीक है? A इक्वल टू B, नॉट इक्वल टू C, गामा जब 120 डिग्री देते हैं, बाकी बाद एंगल 90 डिग्री, इंटायर शेप आई एम नॉट आस्किंग यू टू कंस्ट्रक्ट, दैट इज नॉट द यूनिट सेल माई डियर फ्रेंड, योर यूनिट सेल इज दिस ऑन. Right? This is the unit cell. One third of that. So what you should be doing is that you draw hexagon, whatever, and one third of that cell you mark it in dark to indicate that this is what you mean. Theek hai? Can you draw rhombohedral cell from a cube? Please draw rhombohedral from a cube. So what is a rhombohedral cell? A equal to B equal to C, alpha equal to beta equal to gamma, not equal to 90 degree, not equal to 90 degree. As for the tetragonal cell, what you people have suggested? Is sir, along the cubic axis, one of the cubic edges, either you can compress it or stretch it. So, which direction you should be doing this exercise? Direction to batao na. Bhasha Bhagwan ne di hai na. Itna kharcha kiye hai koi mushkil ke. Aisa mat. Language is very important. That's what indirectly I am trying to hint at. Kiske perpendicular? Kis plane ke? So what I suggest is that in case that cube along any one of the body diagonal, if you start stretching or compressing, will you not get a rhombohedral shape? Is that correct or not? Abhi nahi bhi samajh mein aata koi baat nahi, but this is how nature does it. Right? Similarly, from this rhombohedral, you can get back to this fellow. Janama Bijo teacher. You will be able to do it without any difficulty. So now, how many of you are very good at geometry? Okay, let me construct the example. See it along the rhombohedral axis. That is the axis of distortion of the cube. Right? And the permit, the three primary vector, to be projected on a plane. Three primary vector projected on a plane. कैसा लगा? ये जो अभी हेक्सागन आपने खींचा उसका 120 डिग्री रोटेशन वाला आ जाएगा कि नहीं? आ जाना चाहिए। ओके, प्लेस द क्यूब अलोंग वन ऑफ द बॉडी डायगोनल्स, राइट? So, do you have the three phase vectors? And I want you to put it on the plane. And that plane should be such that the body diagonal is the plane normal. Do you see an equilateral triangle therefore? You'll be able to see it. And if there is an equilateral triangle, you will be able to see that that equilateral triangle, the interior angle is going to be 120 degree in the plane or not? Has to be, if it is becoming an equilateral triangle. So this is how nature connects, the material connects it. And finally, under various condition of processing, it gives rise to all of them. So home task for all of you. The first one is, all the crystal systems must be drawn. There is something like Bravais lattices that must be drawn. And it is given in the Raghavan book. You don't have to do that. The only thing is that you have to draw it physically with pencil and scale. Right? In case you have any question, you can ask me.